DIY on how I build my steel roses. Start off with a piece of HVAC metal, and this one was from a AC install. And I'm using hole saws here just for size and pattern. So I'll go ahead and draw out my disc. There'll be six discs per rose, and each disc will have six petals, except for the first one, which is only three. Here I'm just drawing out where I'm cutting the corners off on each petal. And here they're all drawn out, so I'll go ahead and start cutting them out. This is the bottom leaf on the rose. Yeah, the floor gets a little covered with all these little metal chunks. And believe me, they get stuck in your shoes and get drug all over the place. Beat her up a little bit again. Trim the corners. Bottom, and then the center section, and the three-leaf top, the three-petal top. And here I'm going to go ahead and drill the quarter-inch holes for the carriage bolt. A lot of discs there. I'm baking three roses for the three granddaughters. Okay, I'm using a chip hammer for welding, but it seems to work out pretty good. I start off by hitting on the sides and then move my way to the center. And what I'm trying to do is more or less kind of make a spoon out of each one of the petals. In this here, I'm just putting some lines on the leaves. Okay, let's put her together. It's a three leaf and then a small. I use two mediums and one large. The three leaf is a small and the one behind it is a small. And then the third one is a medium here. And I'm separating the petals so that they're not all lined up. I want to stagger them. Another medium, the large, and then the bottom leaf. Put it all together. I had to take this back apart and put a washer in there, but that is the staggered rose stack. All right, let's go ahead and heat up each petal and go ahead and form it in. I try to get these where they just start glowing red. It's February and it's about 10-15 degrees outside, and that's my salamander kicking in to put a little heat in the garage. Sorry about the noise. Heating up the tops here so I can bend the tops of the petals over. Okay, here's the finished rows. Only two more to go. All right, we're going to go ahead and put the row stems together. Here I'm putting the leaves on the stems. The leaves are copper pipe, 5/8 that I smashed together with a hammer. Cut the silhouette of the leaf out, opened it up, and used the chipping hammer to put the shape and the veins in it. The small stems are copper wire. Then the carriage bolt fits down inside the rose stem, and that's what holds the rose on. And here I'm just soldering it.